Hey now. Here we are talking about Down on the Corner by Creedence Clearwater Revival. You're going to notice if you watch the play-along part of this video that I smiled even more than usual when I was playing this tune because it is fun. And it also just takes me back to being a kid. This was a song that I figured out how to play and I was very, very happy about. So before we get into the song and how to play it, first I want to say if there's anything I'm talking about that you don't understand, there is a fundamentals video on my page, and I can put the link in the comments as well, that will explain some of the stuff if there's some language that you don't get. Also, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and like this video, share it with your friends. One more thing before we get into playing the tune. This song is tuned weird. It's not like, it's like kind of like a quarter step down. I think the band was in tune with itself when they recorded, but not with the world. So when I played along, I tuned down about a quarter of a step. I used a snark. I don't know if you're familiar with these or not, but I tuned down not all the way to, or not all the way to a half step lower, but I tuned down like a quarter of a step. But I tuned back up just to show you what I'm doing here, so you can play along. But if you play along with the song, you might think you're out of tune or that you're doing it wrong, but it's just in a different half step kind of tuning. So I'm going to show you the riff. I am starting with the third fret on the A string, and then I'm going to the fifth fret on the E string, third fret on the E string. So that's the ba, 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 and then it goes back to the third fret on the A. So 3, 5, 3, 3, 3, that's the beginning. And then I repeat the 5 and 3 again, 5, 3, 3. So 3, 5, 3, 3, 3, 5, 3, 3. And now I'm going to the second fret on the A string and then the third fret on the A string. So the whole riff. That's it. 3, 5, 3, 3, 3, 5, 3, 3, 2, 3, 3. That's the first part of it. And then I go to the third fret on the D string. And I'm going to go to the fifth fret on the A. Third fret on the A. Back to 3 on D. Back to 5 on the A. 3 on the A. 2 on the D, 5 on the D. So one more time, I'll do it real slow. 3, 5, 3, 3, 3, 5, 3, 3, 2, 5, 5. Okay, so those are the first two parts of the riff. That's what's happening over the verse. So I'll do this one twice, the one that starts in the A. Repeat that. And then I switch to the D string. Then I go back to the first riff one more time. Now this is me just playing through it and not talking. Change. that's for the verse, okay? The early in the evening, just about supper time. Then when we go to the chorus, the down on the corner, out here in the streets. What I'm doing is I'm playing one on my E string, and then I'm going to go to three on the A, then three on the G. So then back to three on the A. So here it is all together. Now there you're going to hear that I go, or not just I go, they go, and I follow them. So I'm playing this note twice, and this one I play three times, and then I lift up for a second. I do a brief open A string or open string, just a little ghost note. Then I go back up. So when I play this third fret here in the A string, that's got one, two, three, four, but the three is barely audible. Okay. That happens twice. Down on the corner, out in the streets. Then we go back to the verse riff, okay? So it goes verse, chorus, like back and forth. So I'm gonna play the whole thing for you. Here is the verse. In the song, there's a verse and a chorus and a verse and a chorus. There's one part where they play the verse instrumentally, no singing. So you'll hear that, and then it just goes into the regular chorus. After that, there's this little spot where they play just the note C and G, or the third fret on the A string, do 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 do. Same rhythm as the chorus, but it's different chords. So third fret on the A, third fret on the E, then back to third fret on the A. Twice. I'm going to do it real slow. So let's go from the chorus. Down on the corner, out here in the streets, Willie and the poor boys are playing, and the nickel can't be beat. I don't know the words. And then do, 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 do. Alright, so that's for that part of the song. That's after the instrumental verse, okay? Then there's one more verse, and then at the end, the chorus just repeats several times, and it actually fades out. You'll hear me play longer than the song, but that's just repeating the chorus more times than usual. It really ends up being four times. So hopefully that all makes sense to you. For those of you that are playing in notes, this song, basically plays between a C chord and a G chord. The chorus is an F, a C, and a G. If those are things that you don't understand, I'm eventually going to, or I have already, depending on when I upload things, I'm going to put out a video that explains the notes on the fretboard. I think that's very helpful. But if you're just following tabs, that's cool too. Many ways to learn how to play the bass. So please feel free to like this video, subscribe to my channel if you enjoy it. Tell your friends, share this. Thank you again for those of you that are tuning out, and I'll see you on the next one. MattLaBarberMusic.com.